السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام.
السلام
عليكم. Can you hear me?
Yes.
للسيستر. اللهم لا سهل إلا وأن تجعل الحسنة إلى الحسنة بحولك وقوتك يا أرحم الراحمين. بسم الله. My dear sister, in your box page number 287, we will solve the question number 5, the last question on the page. And also you can see it in your Zoom page, you can see it. He said, a garden is made up, who will read, someone will read, Bahar, Bahar, please, you can read.
Yes. Question 5?
Yes, question number 5.
A garden is made up of a rectangular patch of grass and two semicircular vegetable patches. If the dimensions of the two rectangular patches are 16 meters, then...
So, we can see it in the shape. We can see the two semicircles and we can see the rectangle in the middle. And we can see the two dimensions, 16 meters and 8 meters. So the first question will be, the first question, before completing, who can find the radius of the circle? The length of the radius of the circle.
Mister.
Yes.
It will be 4.
So you can answer directly. Open your mic and answer. Don't raise your hand.
It will be 4. Sorry, it will be 4.
You can answer.
It will be 4, Mr.
It will be 4. Yes, it's a 2. Excellent. Why it's 4? Can you see that it equals 8? That's right. This one comes to the diameter of the circle. So the diameter equals 8. So the radius equals 8 divided 2 equals 4 centimeters. Yes. So, the givens now are 16, I know the length of the rectangle, and I know the width of the rectangle, and also I know the radius of the circle. Any problem?
No, Mr. Explain again, Mr.
What?
Explain it again.
I'm explaining, or only I'm writing the givens. Number one, 16 and 8 are the dimensions of the rectangle. Any problem?
No.
Number 2, the radius of the circle or the radius of the semicircle. The diameter of the semicircle will be 8. Can you see 8?
Yes.
Good. So what will be the radius of the circle?
4.
Yes, excellent. So divide 8 by 2, so the radius of the circle will be only 4. Now, Bahar, please complete. Complete reading.
Respectively, calculate A, the perimeter of the garden.
Stop. Number one, you have to calculate the perimeter of the garden. How to calculate it? Number one, who can tell me the perimeter of the garden equals what?
Mr. Lens plus width all multiplied.
What?
Length plus width all multiply 2.
This is not rectangle. The garden is all the shape. The whole shape is...
Okay.
So the garden is 16. That's right?
Yes.
Two arcs and another 16. That's right?
Yes.
So I need an excellent student to explain how to find the perimeter of this garden.
Mr.
Yes, you can.
It is the radius of the semi. It is the diameter of the semicircle. So divide by 2, it will be 4. So we'll find the circumference of the circle. We will find the circumference of the circle, and then we will divide by 2 to get the perimeter of the semicircle. And then in the another semicircle,
Semicircles. So what's your opinion to find the circumference of one circle, one time?
Okay, no problem.
Okay, so to repeat.
And then, 8 divided by 2 equal 4. Then we will find the circumference. Circumference equal 2 by r. 2 multiply 3.14 multiply 4 equal. Wait, I will find it.
Equals 8 by
r. Okay.
Also, you can say the circumference of circle equals by multiply the length of the diameter by multiply d. So it will be 8 multiply by. Finish. That's right.
Okay.
Then you
okay. Then we will find the perimeter of the triangle equal length plus width all multiply 2.
Six. Then you will add only 16 and the 16.
Why we will find the perimeter of the triangle and then we will add?
The perimeter is the length of the outer line.
Okay.
Only the outer line. And the outer line is circle
16.
And 16 and another 16. That's right?
Okay.
So this will be. This will be the perimeter of the shape. This will be the perimeter of the shape. So the perimeter of the shape will be circumference of circle plus 16 plus 16. Any problem?
No.
And you find this. My son, in part B, he asked me to find the total area of the garden. How to find the total area of the garden?
Sir. I cannot understand why did we get this, from where did we get this 16?
16? The length, he gave it to me. He gave me the length of the rectangle equals 16. Can you see it?
Why don't we find the perimeter of the rectangle and the perimeter of the circle and then...
Very good. This is method of thinking, but it's not good. My son, or my daughters, my sons and daughters, if you want to find the perimeter of two shapes, it's wrong to find the perimeter of each shape, then to add the two shapes again. Why? The perimeter of this shape equals what? Equals this side, 16. And the arc, then the other side. The other side, 16, then another arc. We wouldn't go inside the shape. So we wouldn't add, we will not add this 8. And we will not add this 8. So it's wrong to find the perimeter of the rectangle and the perimeter of the circle and add the two shapes together. Understood? It's not true. But in area, we can find the area of the rectangle and the area of the circle together.
Mr. So the perimeter, Mr. will be 57.12.
So the perimeter will be 8 by
plus
32. 16 plus 16 equals 32. Equals?
Equal.
57.12, no problem to find it. So, who asked me before, understood?
Yes.
So if we have two shapes together, he asked me to find the perimeter of the two shapes. For example, if I have something like that, and...
Mr. Land, will make this method in the total area of...
So I have here two rectangles. Can you see it? If he asked me to find the total perimeter or the perimeter of the shape, it's wrong to find the perimeter of the first rectangle and the perimeter of the second rectangle together. Wrong. So it will be this side, can you see the side? This one, plus the other side. So the perimeter will be only the outer line, the length of the outer line. I will not enter the shape. Understood?
Mr. And we will use the same method to find the total area on.
No, the total area we will find the area of the circle and the area of. And we will the two areas together. No problem.
Okay, this method only in print.
Please, my sons and daughters, don't add the perimeter. If you have any questions, you can ask now.
Mr.
Yes.
Mr. Your voice not clear. I can't understand.
My voice?
Yes.
There's an echo, Mr.
Mr. Echo and very loud.
And there's a softness in the voice.
It's better now?
Mr. The same.
No, same.
So let's close the mics. Close it all. So mute all. It's better? My sons, it's better? So, Hur, you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. So, let's complete. If you have any question, you can raise your hand. Hur, your mic opens, you can talk. Don't raise your hand, you can talk. Ask Hur.
I asked, really sorry, I used my hand by mistake.
Okay, so we finished the question number 5. To find the perimeter, we will add the circumference of the circle and 16 and another 16. But to find the total area of the garden, we will find the area of the two shapes, one circle and the rectangle, then we will add it together. Now let's start our lesson. Today we will talk about the total surface area. The total surface area and the lateral surface area. Total surface area of cuboid and this one. So, what do you know about cuboid? Anyone want to ask or want to answer? He can open his mic.
Yes, Mr.
Then close it again after answer.
I know, Mr.
Yes.
Cuboid is a 3D shape.
Cuboid is a 3D shape, very good.
So the area should be like the three dimensional length multiplied width multiplied height.
This is volume. So this is volume of the cuboid. But yeah. Today we are talking about the total surface area. So cuboid is a 3D shape, contains how many faces?
Six.
Consisting of six faces?
Six.
Okay, so each face is rectangle. So each face of the six faces is rectangle. Number one, to find the total surface area of the cuboid, we have two things. We have sides, and the area of the sides, we can name it lateral area. So the lateral area is the area of the side. The area of the side faces. So we have four side faces. 1 minute. 1, 2, 3, 4. And also we have two faces. Two faces. So the total surface area of the cuboid equal the lateral area plus area of two faces. Plus area of two faces. Let's see. Here. Total surface area of cuboid equals lateral surface area plus area of two faces. The first part is the lateral surface area. Lateral surface area of the prisms equals perimeter of the base multiply height. The lateral surface area of the prisms, my sons, the cuboid is one of the prisms. prisms like cube, cuboid, cylinder, and triangular prism. So the left-hand surface area of the prism equals perimeter of the base multiplied height. But the base here in the rectangle is, the base here in the cuboid is a rectangle. So the perimeter of the base equals 2 by, sorry, the perimeter, it's not true. The perimeter of the rectangle equals 2 multiply length plus width. This is the perimeter of the base. So the perimeter of the rectangle equals 2 multiply length plus width. We will multiply this perimeter by the height, the length of the height. And this will give me the lateral surface area. So the lateral surface area of the cuboid equals 2 multiply length plus width multiply height. 2 multiply length plus width multiply height. Then we will add the area of the two bases. The base also is rectangle. And the area of the rectangle equal length multiply width. But we have two rectangles. So it will, two bases means two rectangles. So it will be 2 multiply length plus width. So the total surface area of the cuboid equals 2 length plus width multiply height plus 2 length width. I multiply 2 by length and width and height. So the result will be 2LH plus 2WH plus 2LW. The last step, I'll explain it again. We will multiply 2 and H by L. So it will be 2LH. We will multiply 2 and H by W. So it will be 2WH. At the end, we have 2LW. We will put it as it is. Now, we will take 2 as a common factor. Take 2. So the remainder will be, from the first term, the remainder is LH. From the second term, the remainder is WH. From the third term, the remainder will be LW. And this is the rule of the total surface area of the cuboid. The total surface area of the cuboid equals 2 multiply LH plus WH plus LW. Again, 2 multiply LH plus WH plus LW. Now, back to the book. Here, he gave me an exercise A. Who will read it? Mustafa Saleh, you can read.
We calculate the surface area of the cuboid shown left. Total area of the of top and bottom equal 2 by 7 by
Mustafa, we will not use this rule to find the total surface area. We will not find the total surface area in three steps. Only we will find it in one step. We will say the total surface area equals
2 by
open bracket
LH plus LW or closing bracket.
Yes, very good. Plus WH. Yes.
Plus LW.
Very good. Mustafa.
LW.
Before solving, you can write X L equals what? W equals what? And H equals what? And H. Mustafa, what is the length of the cuboid?
10 centimeters.
10? And the width?
The width is 5.
5 is height.
Sorry, 7.
7? And the height is 5. So length is 10, width is 5, width is 7, and the height is 5.
And the height, yes.
Now, substitute with the numbers 10, 7, 5 in the rule. So it will be 10 multiply 5, 50.
Yeah, 10 plus 5, 50. Plus 7 by 5 equals 35.
What?
Means it will be 75. 75 plus...
Mustafa, so it's 50 plus 35?
85.
It's good. Plus what?
Plus LW, which is 10 centimeter... 10?
10 multiply what?
10 by 7 equals 70.
Yes, we will add.
So it's 80.
So 0 plus 5 plus 0 equals 5. 3 plus 7, 10 plus 5, 15.
Equal 153.
155. So we will multiply 155 by what? 155 by 2, by this 2. So the answer will be 310. It's clear, my sons?
Yes.
If you have any question, you can ask directly. You can open your mic and ask.
If I change the length to be the width, like if I said that 7 is the length, will you consider my answer as a one?
So 7 is the width, but this will give you the same answer. Don't afraid this will give you the same answer, but 7 is the width and 10 is the length. But if you change it, length equals 7 and width equals 10, this will give you also the same answer. No problem. Any other questions?
Okay.
Adil? Nothing? Okay, so, and don't forget to write at the end the centimeter square, because we are finding the area, and the area will be in a square unit. Now, the second exercise, he said, the total surface area of the cylinder. Let's find the total surface area of the cylinder together. The total surface area of the cylinder will be, again, the cylinder one of the prisms.
So the 2π by r.
1 minute, Mustafa. So the total surface area of the cylinder will be curved area plus area of two bases. That's right. Curved area plus area of two bases. The curved area will be perimeter of the base multiplied height. But the base is a circle. So circumference of the circle equal 2 by r. 2 by r multiply height, what is this? This is the lateral surface area. This is lateral surface area. So lateral surface area or curved surface area equals 2 by r h. 2 by r, circumference of the base, multiplied by h, and the h is the height of the cylinder. Then we will add the area of the two bases. Each base is a circle, so the area of the circle equal by r squared. But we have two circles, so it will be 2 by r squared. And now let's simplify the rule. Total surface area of the cylinder equals, what's your opinion to take 2 as a common factor? Also, we can take y as a common factor. We can take this y, and also we can take r as a common factor. R common factor. Now, open bracket to write the rest. Divide 2 by r h by 2 by r. 2 divided 2 equals 1. Y divided y equals 1. And r divided r equals 1. Only we have h. Plus 2 by r squared divided 2 by r equals only r. Zulaikat, do you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. I'm asking you because you told me you can't hear anything. It's better.
No, it's better. Okay. Yes.
So the total surface area of the cylinder equals, memorize with me now, the simplest form of the rule, 2 by r multiply h plus r. 2 by r multiply h plus r. 2 by r multiply h plus r. Now, back to the question. Part B, he said.
Can I read?
Yes, you can read, pleasure.
If the height of a cylinder is 7 centimeters and the radius of its circular.
1 minute. 1 minute, my daughter. He said if the height is 7, so he gave me what?
Height.
He gave me h, height. Very good. Complete.
And the radius of its circle is 3.
And he gave me r. Now, h equals 7 centimeters. R equals 3 centimeters.
Calculate its surface area.
Doctor, you can't solve it?
Me?
Yes, you.
It will be 2 by multiplied by 3, open bracket, 3 plus 7.
You memorize the rule?
Yes, which is...
The rule of the total surface area said, total surface area of the cylinder equal 2 by r multiply h plus r. 2 by r multiply h plus r. 2 by r multiply h plus r. Now, we will substitute in the rule. We have the radius, so it will be the radius equal 3. So it will be 2 by multiply 3, multiply 3 plus 7. 3 and 7, the radius and the height. This will give you 60 by, and this will be the total surface area of the cylinder.
It's 18.495592.
Okay, very good. Any problem, my sons?
188.
And the next page now is asking me to find the total surface area of key point and the total surface area of the cylinder. But 1 minute. If he gave me...
Easy.
Yes, I know it's easy. But if he gave me, my son's total surface area, if he gave me the total surface area, for example, the total surface area equals 102. And the length of the cuboid, not now, and the length of the cuboid equals 5 centimeters. The width equals 2 centimeters. Find the height. Find the height. This is a big problem. That's right.
We can make the height as the subject.
Yes, very good. Excellent. Who said that?
4.
You are excellent, my daughter. My daughter said, Mr. Abdurrahman, I have the rule of the total surface area. Total surface area. The total surface area of the cuboid equals 2LH.
Plus WH.
Plus 2 plus 2WH plus 2LW. That's right. Or we can take 2 as a common factor outside the bracket. Yes, 2. She said, I'll make H the subject.
Mr. I can't hear you.
It's better now? This is what cut again? Okay. So I'll make H the subject of this question, of this equation. How to make H the subject? Step number one, divide total surface area by 2. That's right. That's right.
How, Mr.?
To cancel this 2, 2 here in the right hand side multiplied by the bracket. So the first step, I'll divide the other side by 2.
Okay.
So this is equals LH plus WH plus LW. That's right?
Yeah.
Okay. The second step, I'll divide half the total surface area. So the first step, I'll find the half of the total surface area. I'll divide it by 2. The second step, I'll divide half the total surface area. I'll subtract, LW. So it will be total surface area over 2 minus LW equals LH plus
W.
Very good, excellent. Now, the third step, I'll write H, I'll take H as a common factor. So, total surface area over 2 minus
LW.
LW equals H multiply L plus what?
W.
W, excellent. The last step, I'll divide the left hand side by L plus W. So, H equals this is H equals, I write it using my hand here, H equals total surface area over 2 minus L W over L plus W. Your voice, please. So this will give you the height. I think also, if you wrote the rule total surface area equals and substitute with the numbers, give you the total surface area equals 100. So write 100. Equals what? Do you remember? 2 multiply, he gave me the length. Okay, let's solve the exercise. In your book,
Mr. Serbo was asked exercise that we must find the height or.
Yes, page number 289.
That's 2.
Question number 2. In question number 2, he said, calculate the height. He gave me length equals 5, width equals 6, equals 104. What we will do? I write total surface area
over 2
equals what? Equals 2 multiply LH. That's right?
Yes.
So 5H. L equals 5. And we don't know the value H. Plus LW. L equals 5. And the W equals 6. 5 multiplied 6 equals 30. Plus WH. W equals 6. And we don't know H equals what? So it will be 6H. And the total surface area equals 104. So instead of total surface area, I can write 104. Now, this is equation of H, what? And I think you can solve it. That's right?
Yes.
I'll add 5H and 6H, and the sum will be 11H plus 30. And the next step, I'll divide by this 2. I'll divide 100 by this 2. So 104 divided 2 equals 52. 52 equals what? 52 equals what?
11H.
Yes, 11H plus 30. Now, can you find the value of the height? 11H.
Yes.
We will subtract what?
52 minus 30.
Yes, we will subtract 30. 52 minus 30.
Is 22.
Equals 22. So the height equals 22 divided 11 over 11 equals 2. So the height equals 2.
We can check it. We can check the surface area.
Yes.
We can check the answer. Height by finding the surface area from the height we get.
By substituting by 2 in the root. Yes, very good. Excellent. Now, my sons and daughters, if you have any question, you can ask me. The first question, 1 minute. The first question is asking me to find the total surface area. He gave me the length, width, and height. So this is direct equation. We can calculate it. No problem. In the second question, maybe it's harder than the first one. He gave me the total. Yes, he gave me the total surface area, width, and length, and he's asking me to find the height. Now, if you want to ask, you can ask.
Mister, total surface area equal to L or bracketed?
No, 2 bracket. 2 multiply 3 things. This is not L, this is bracket. 2.
Okay.
Ahmed, this is bracket. Okay. I think it's better now. Now, so no questions? Alhamdulillah, no questions. So question number 3, let's solve it together. Who can solve the question number 3? It's a direct question. He gave me the radius and the height. And he's asking me to calculate the total surface area of the cylinder. Who can find it?
Me, mister.
So what about the girls? Hold.